even surprisingly big bands aren't selling that many units these days. So it just doesn't work that way if you don't have the sales history to back it up. And a lot of people don't understand that. Hey, so I wanted to talk about something that comes up a lot, which is distribution companies. There's a few angles to this that I want to approach. First and foremost, there's a lot of bands who seem to think they can get a deal direct with one of the bigger distribution companies like The Orchard or Ingrooves or something. That's not going to happen. To get a direct deal with one of the bigger distribution companies, like you see some of these forward-thinking bigger bands doing who don't have a label, they're selling a certain amount of units, which makes it justified for The Orchard to take them on as an individual account, right? Like, Trivium sells more records in a year probably than a label like Ripple Music, which is crazy, but like that's just what it is. So of course Trivium can get their own account at MVD or The Orchard or whatever, but like you can't get, as an unsigned band who's like small and playing local shows and hasn't toured a lot and isn't like selling thousands and thousands of copies, you're not going to get a one-on-one distribution deal with a bigger company. And if you are offered one, I'd be very careful about that, because they're probably taking you for a hell of a cut. And the thing is, the amount that some of these distribution companies can do for you, for a tiny band with no support or whatever, relative to like CD Baby, is relatively minor. Like, you could either go to CD Baby and they take like a smaller chunk, like 20% or something, I think, which is cool. Or you could like get gouged to be put on all the same digital platforms and not get any physical distribution. Like, that's kind of the issue. Why should anyone offer you, a bigger person, offer you physical distribution if you're not selling any copies in California? Because like, even surprisingly big bands aren't selling that many units these days, so it just doesn't work that way if you don't have the sales history to back it up, and a lot of people don't understand that. Now, a lot of people ask me about DistroKid versus TuneCore versus CD Baby. I've always been a TuneCore fan, just because I like the one-off payment idea, but there's a lot of different options and just a variety of tools online that you can use. So you're really going to have to just look for yourself and see what makes the most sense for your band. I think all three of those have their own proponents and advocates and good reasons to use them. I don't really see anyone doing much better than the others. All of them, if I'm being super honest, all of them will say like, oh, we can definitely help get you on playlists, or oh, we can definitely help get more eyes on what you're doing. But like, I haven't really seen any of them like really move the needle regularly for artists who didn't already have a bunch of stuff going for them. You know, like they can definitely help with that, but like only if people already give a shit. If people don't already give a shit, you're kind of boned. So what I'm saying is do some research on which of the bigger independent distribution companies you should be using. Don't expect one of the like cool kid ones that like major labels are using to pick you up. Simple as that.